Anthony Jannik.
I'm Jason Android.
I will represent the team company. So my friend Simon, Katrina, and Lily, so they will do the editing behind. So this is a G4T testing, which is a point of test. So you can see this is the apparatus for point of test. So now I will give Jason to present.
First of all, this is a testing material. So we need to adjust the source with testing material. So we need to adjust the
After we release, then we put the rock inside the apparatus, so we start to pump it. In the same time, we need to
check the reading. So this is a testing sample. We test until this sample is cracked. So in the same time, we take the reading where this sample is cracked.
So the reading is 50 MPa.
Right.
So the conclusion is this material is 50 MPa.
Right. In the conclusion, we can take the first row of the sample. First, we need to calculate the area. You see the right hand side. The area I calculate is 787.35 millimeter square. After that, the question given 8 kilonewton. So you see the left hand side, the graph, which is the first one, which is the y-axis 8 kilonewton. So you mark a straight line to the perpendicular of the line, then you marking to the horizontal line, which is the DE square equal to 1002.49. After that, you need to calculate size of correction factor, which size of correction factor can determine on the graph, which is left hand side, the bottom graph. The correction factor is 0.7. Hence, you need to calculate corrector point load strength, which is, the formula is 8 times 1000 over 1002.49. The IS is 7.98 megapascal. Finally, you need to calculate point load strength 50, which is IS times DE over 50 to the power of 0.45. So the answer is 6.50 megapascal. So 6.50 megapascal, you can determine on the graph. You can directly determine the types of rock by using the megapascal. Thank you.